आफ्टरनून सर। सर गुड आफ्टरनून।
मैम रफ मैम
यू आर ऑन टाइम।
आई शुड बी मैम
ओके सर, वी आर ट्राइंग टू डू अ लाइव स्ट्रीमिंग यूट्यूब।
ओह फाइन फाइन सुपर सुपर मैम सुपर मैम
दैट्स व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग आउट।
नो प्रॉब्लम नो प्रॉब्लम मैम हेलो हेलो। हेलो। அப்படியே கேக்குது சார், டைரக்டாவே கேக்குது।
afternoon everyone. Shall we start, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So today we are going to have a meeting. Scholars management tips and tools. There is K. Ramasamy, who is working as the college librarian at EBM, Government Art College for Women.
So in Raninath Gurum College, we have 10 research departments, 5 science and 5 arts and commerce departments. So today, I cordially welcome the research department of English to take over the session. So Jyoti Kriva, Deepa Sia, Vivita, and Jansi Rani, along with the team of professors, Dr. Jila Ma'am and Dr. Jasmine, and the head of the department of research department of English, are together here. So they will have this exam. Welcome all.
Welcome to the webinar, the conference. The title is Reference Tips and Tools QAC, National Webinar, Raninath Government College for Women, Tenerbelli. Have Mr. Dr. K. Ramasamy, librarian in Government Arts College. Now I would like to give welcome address.
A very good afternoon, one and all. We have been there in every step of the way. We want to deliver the welcome address and also excited and feel blessed about this role. The essence of great leadership is influence and not authority. Dr. C.P. Maitri, the principal of Raninath Government College for Women. We welcome you, ma'am. Next, I would like to welcome Dr. K. Ramasamy, the Chief Guest, the Librarian of MBM, Government Art College for Women. He is an author, writer, and educator teacher, and he is the source of to be the resource person of the webinar today. Scholars may add one thing to explore and contribute more to the community. With this note, I would like to welcome our organizing to this webinar, Dr. V. Darling Selvi, IQA coordinator, Raninath Government College for Women. Welcoming all the professors and I am extremely happy to welcome students and the team, the audience who have gathered here. I hope that all of you have an interesting and stimulating session, and I sincerely wish that this webinar will be a great success. I extend a very warm welcome to everybody gathered here. Thank you.
Jansi, you are muted.
Hello, am I audible for you?
Yeah, now you are audible.
And now I would ask Ms. Jyothi Kirba to give introduction about the speaker.
My greatest interest of the class of the MBA scholars.
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Okay, fine, ma'am. If there is any problem with the ma'am.
Okay, sure, sir.
Thank
sure.
You, thank you, ma'am. Thank you. The most respected and honorable principal of Rani Anna Government College for Women, ma'am, and the organizer of this national level scholars meet, Dr. V. Darling Selvi, IQC coordinator, faculty members and students of the college, and the faculty members and students of other very, very joyful afternoon. It gives me to be part of this national level webinar on conference management and tools. Let me take this opportunity to thank the principal and the organizer for having given me this wonderful opportunity of meeting you all gathering. So dear, these days we talk more about research in every piece of, every walks of our academic life, because almost all the institutions, they go for accreditation or they go for some kind of national ranking or international ranking. In all those accreditation and ranking, research plays a very prominent role. Even when you people are applying for some from institutions like Department of Science and Technology, UGC major minor project, or impressed, whatever it may be, one important criteria on basis of which elect obligations. If you take a regular faculty members, if you want to go to the next level in the academics, then you should have the papers, or these many researchers, or the freshers when they're applying for some post, either assistant professor or associate professor. The important component of the evaluation is that their research performance during the past few years. The number of papers, the quantity and quality of publications have taken into consideration, and that is why he started giving a lot of importance to research peers. Got? So what a research can be? Anything. See, for example, you're doing your PG, you are at the end of your second year, you do a project, and you publish your project, research. MPhil scholars, they do dissertation. PG, PhD scholars, they make a thesis at the end of their research work. Or even after completing their PhD, some people post and you publish your papers in some journals, or you write some book chapters, or you write papers for various conferences, or you do some kind of research fund from various agencies. See, all these things can be termed definitely as research. See, question comes here. So what are the various components of a journal article or a conference paper or book? They may run from 5 pages to 10 pages. If you take parts of a thesis or dissertation or project report, 300 pages. So basically, if you go through all these components, you'll come to understanding that, so whatever may be the research work you do, they basically will have the following components. So definitely, in your author's affiliation, then you have kind of an abstract, you have keywords, then you have introduction, then you have a review of literature, then you talk about your methodology, then you talk about your data analysis interpretation, then findings, suggestions, conclusion, then bibliography, then appendices. So this is what a normal research work will include. But if you ask what are the components of any research paper, I should tell you that any research paper will have only two components. One, what you write on your own, and what you take from others. So basically, it will consist of these two components. You may ask a question, so research is what we do by ourselves. Why should we take content from others? What is the need for us to get some kind of ideas, things from others? Where do we use others' content? So that kind of questions may arise on your minds. So these are the places where you will make use of others' content. See, for example, when you are writing a work, giving something on e-banking or digital marketing, something like that. See, when you are writing a paper on all these options, part of to give a background of this particular concept. When this particular concept originated, how it has grown, is there any theory for that? Is there a definition for this particular concept given by great personalities? So when you are going to give a background information, when you are giving definition for, you have to depend on others' work, you have to borrow the content from others' paper. First thing. Second is review of literature, obviously. So the review of literature is very, very important component of any research work. See, you undertake a research, you should find out what is the research gap that exists in your field. How to find the research gap? The only way is to conduct a comprehensive review of literature. So only when you go through what research did happen in the previous years, you'll be able to understand, so what kind of researchers were there, what kind of research they were undertaking, what were their objectives, methodologies, how did they collect data, how did they analyze the data, what are their findings, what are their suggestions, and study and what and all they have not studied. That is where you will get the what is the research gap that exists in your field that will for research. Fine. You understand how research was conducted with the ICANN methodology, what kind of data collection tool they used, my previous research, and also you say research was various standards for carrying out the testing, ICANN kinds of standards. All these things can be used only when you do a thorough review of literature. So review of literature is nothing but going through the works of previous scholars. So obviously you are depending on them. And third and finally, see after you have a lot of findings, there is a section in every research school. So they are where you are trying to find out to what extent your findings, your own are in tune. What extent you are finding not in the same that so obviously as you have a clear idea of what others found, you cannot compare and contrast your findings with that of others. See, in all these areas you have to depend on others' content. So you can see the screen, a particular article on ovarian cancer. The introduction part, so they have made use of these words. That means they have taken content, they have taken some content from Philly's paper, or Bradley's RAP paper, or so they have taken content papers so that they can write each layer very transfer and a deliberate introduction. Fine. So the introduction part being needed. And secondly, review section. So in the review section, you have analyzed, who already examined, maybe have highlighted, or have suggested, Buckler observed. See what previous researchers have found out. We do all these kind of things naturally, you depend on others' work. Then discussion section, after you get your which have finding same kind of results of what you have got for, okay, our results are similar to, our results are consistent with, so there are whatever studies which are not having same results, so these are some contrasting results, so in real contrast with other, all these you have to and you need depend on the content of other researchers. Maybe you may have referred a book or a journal article or a thesis or an interview or a YouTube video or a newspaper article or a TV interview, whatever it may be, you have to take a fine. So when we start taking content from others, so this is what we started with. We for copying and control V is for pasting, but we stop there. We proceeded further. Control A, you select all. You select ROC, then control V, your assignment, your seminar is ready. Some people even go to next step, control P. So control A to select and then everything in the Word file, you can print also. What happens in the research world, especially when you are thankful to internet information available, we started making use of the information very, very liberally. Fine. So what happens? That is the manners of doing things from others and using it. Then that is called the plagiarism. Plagiarism is, so you are taking the content of others, but instead of mentioning their name, instead of acknowledging them, instead of them, those content, those methods in your research work, as if they are your own. People, those who happen to really understand own concept, own ideas of the author, and so you borrow from many plagiarism. So in order to avoid the plagiarism, terms are being undertaken by the researchers and faculty members, one such prominent measure help you to get rid of the problem of plagiarism is proper and of resources. Whatever resources you are using in your research work, acknowledge all those resources. What are these acknowledgement? Acknowledge means you are going to thank them. You are going to show your gratefulness to them. Bring their ideas, their content, their you are making use of theirs, not yours. Other content, you have to acknowledge them. You have to be thankful to them. And what kind of sources? Anything. As I told you, it can be a book or a journal article or a blog post or a YouTube video or an article or an interview or a book. The mass plagiarism. Fine. Because you are asking us to acknowledge others' content. So why should we cite? Why should we acknowledge others' work? It's very simple. Because we are taking the ideas of others, content of others. Author, the correct author should be getting it for this. So to give it, you have to cite. Second point, for example, you are writing article. So your article is published. You are first, they be reading your paper. After reading your paper, they would like to know the references you use for your research work. They want to identify and locate all the references, whatever you use for your research work. So if you have reference, then they will be able to locate all those references for their research work. This is the second point. And third point, if you are writing all the sources properly and accurately, escape from the problem of plagiarism, third reason, then see, you're having some idea, so you want to support your ideas, you want to give a lot of ideas, then you can make use of others' content. For example, you want to say that, for example, the students of Ranyana Government College has very seriously do their treatment. So how to prove this? See, you have to find out what are the various studies conducted about the Government College, whatever the findings are there, all those findings are brought into limelight. You have to bring all those finds together so that people will have a strong opinion, strong belief that is supported by proper evidences. So you should cite them. And you have to ask the particular ideas that can be supported by a number of your school of ideas. Finally, our responsibility to give respect to our faith. If I am doing research on image processing, I should be thankful to them. I should be grateful to them. I should thank. That is the only way I can advance their research findings. Fine. So because of all, we have to acknowledge the sources. Fine. Good. So what are the tips? One thing which are to be acknowledged in your research work. So what are the various things I should write in my research work? The first thing is direct quotations. Means, for example, you are copying two lines exactly from a research paper or a journal article or a e-journal, and you are reproducing it as such. That is called direct quotation. That means without changing anything, as such you are using. If you are using a direct quotation, then you have to accuse of that quotation. So direct quotations can be of two kinds. Either they are short quotations or quotations. So longer quotations are called as block quotations. The shorter quotations maximum 40 words. If it is more than 40 words or 4 lines, no, that is called longer quotations or. So if it's a short quotations, see the quotation, so I mean double quotes. The same time, if the number of words go beyond four, you should make it as a paragraph. Okay, you are introducing the quotation. Here comes the quotation. You are typing the quotation. you read, you understand, understood, you are writing them in your own language style, in your own sentence construction style. So when you are producing, reproducing your own style, in your own idea, that is called paraphrasing. But only if it is a paraphrase. So you have paraphrased, the original content is not yours. You have borrowed the content from others. The other people have to be. So even if you are paraphrasing, you have to properly cite the source. And secondly, some people even they go for partial paraphrasing. So you take one paragraph from one research paper, you make few corrections, few additions. You say it is my original content. You make few changes. In that is paraphrasing. You have the original language completely. That's why that's only can be paraphrasing. Please understand, even when you are if there are 5 or 6 words are there, you feel those words and you want to switch. In that case, even those 5 or 6 within the double, but not double. So for example, driver was driving miles per hour long. We do normally copy this text and put it in some paraphrasing tools that will be automatically converting this. For example, teen driver has ran this for hours while driving very quickly yesterday. So this is actually the clear sign. So what is the best way of paraphrasing? Read over. You should rewrite it in your day. The previous day, a young driver lost control while driving his vehicle at a high speed. And you have to mention the person from whom you have borrowed this particular sentence. That is the correct way of paraphrasing. Second example, see this one quotation. You are converting this quotation to paraphrase. But you want to retain just like of all. If you want to retain these 4 or 5 paraphrasing, there also you should enclose these in double quotes. Otherwise, that will lead to something called plagiarism. So you should acknowledge all the direct quotations, all the paraphrasing, and third summaries. See, sometimes what happens is that so there is a page article. You read the entire article, and you fill in this for a summary. Writing a summary text that people are writing, maybe a literature, you know, summary review. So when you are summarizing each part, you have to acknowledge the person whose paper. So that phrases and summaries are to be properly acknowledged. Not only that, see, for example, you are taking some tables, some figures, some diagrams, some images from various sources. Even when you are in all these different items offline or from online, you have to prompt them. Not only that, from some lecture online, you are talking to some friends. So, you based some idea on some lectures or personal communications, even though they are not printed, even though they are not published, it is a moral responsibility for all the researchers and cite all these personal communications also. So, all these personal communications also are to be properly defined. So I have just given you a list of various items that are to be acknowledged while you are preparing your research paper. Now, you can ask a question. Sir, what kind of things need not be acknowledged on the research paper? Things like your own ideas, your own theories, your own images, your own diagrams, your own graphs, or your own research. So you need not acknowledge first point. Second point, common knowledge. This is something which is there everywhere. So facts. These facts are available in almost all the reference books, wherever, whatever books, all these basic information are available. So these common and facts, most of the reference books, for these you need not give any acknowledgement. For example, you talk about current events. You say that Mr. Star, Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu. So you need not give any, you need not find and give any particular. Mahatma Gandhi was a very famous freedom fighter. So you need not give any acknowledgement for geographical facts. See, India, well, India. Things not there are knowledge questions. For example, the sun rises in the east. Drinking water is good in summer. So these are the common knowledge aspects which don't warrant any kind of acknowledgements from the researchers. Fine. The same way, there are familiar proverbs, there are well-known quotations, widely known terms, you know, acknowledge all these things. You can go use something like gets covered, we shall overcome, the early bird gets the worm. So they are very, very popular sayings. So these and all things and all need not be acknowledged. But when you are going to make all these common knowledge very specific, then it may warrant a kind of saying. If you say that drinking water is good for you in summer, you need not acknowledge. But if you want to say that drinking 2.67 is good for the people of this statement,
sir, excuse me, you are not. Sir, we couldn't hear you. Please.
garden hanging in the after date now sequence reference number reference that quotation in this can be described rather it can make use of it but when you are arranging all arranging in the same orange you use them in your research number one in the end all one and you write down Association for Social Humanities, Languages, then IEEE for Engineering. Now, sir, how to prepare and how to cite all these references in all these things? How can I use different methods? Apps are available to say there is can get a book, can prepare indexes, absolute no problem. And can use of online generators are there, online citation your own and fourth option softwares which can be downloaded by you. You can save it in your system just as if you are using your gemma, make use of all these and you can check the references. Four methods. First method, to get the books, please go to this particular site, izlib.org, is a home page. Click on books, and here, technological assessment edition available. You can download the entire book. Ninth edition, you can download Chicago Math Free. You can download the manuals. Can be second, go to the MS Word. Reference. You click box. You can generate third on level. bb.org, citationmachine.net, netfast.com, Scott. So all these are be used by you get references. Then all the softwares. So there are some software which can be done, like e.com. We have very popular version is also Mendeley or Zotero, both on the soft product and the can. And these are the identity of OPA. Yes. Good eye screen, window screen. Okay. My card, if you go to the creating references, here they can insert. Click on add new soap. What you can use that and whatever you want. Okay, so one just hold. You can use that to present a report. I can even city or New Delhi, that is Publisher City, and publish
Sir, you are not audible. Sir, we can't hear you.
Sir, you are not audible, sir.
Question. You can just please provide. There will be prepare references manually, also manual entry. So I do everything online now. It is a manual choose. Then you want to prepare reference for section, conference page, article, broadcast. We can go on with here, book, article, you can in molten state. First side, you can find that element. I just show you where you can download just the blog as your see the over mouse is called file click the window. It has got for each and five items any on in the third. Then you can add for example, into your system. It's very, very simple. Okay, my profile. I go to my profile. Bring deep text. Click on export. Now, my all my words now are expanded. Give a single right click. Click on save us. I am saving it as save. Now file. What I use that? Software. Okay. I just go to the file. Import. I click on import. I say next. I have to choose the file called where is there. I say open. Click place and next. So it is importing all references. Yeah, I am not, I just went to Google or everything into export here. I am importing all the my Zotero software. So finish. All the 46 items are imported. Now 46 items have come. All the items are correct. Create bibliography from items. AP 7 edition, I want copy to clipboard, go to MS Word. Now 46 mind, whatever found in Google's cause, those are now my MS words. Very, very simple. The same way that you can put time direct, put the file text. All those words, you can import all. Then come here, this is an option, item by item. If you click this, you can enter ID number, password ID, whatever you need to exhibit, all those icons. Okay. I just pin number. Search the bottom. I will also add just to go and that you can do.
Article. See,
publish in the journal Green Hemisphere, please come and sit inside your room. That is the beauty of this Sentiment software, which I have been using for good. So I would strongly suggest all these factors to help you to. And once your time is saved, rate more on that is very, very important. Fine. But you are at my father's, you are the father's, you should have the research intended for free research work so that your name will be always best wishes. Thank you so much for
that.
on behalf of the government